Let's go from healing the sick to cleaning the air. Number six was supposed to be a way to wean us off fossil fuels by unlocking the energy potential of our plentiful and comparatively less yucky corn. So how did that ethanol mandate and subsidy regime work out, Peter Suderman?
It also did exactly the opposite of what it was supposed to do. This is a great one. I mean, it has done almost nothing that anyone who was in favor of subsidizing corn ethanol for fuel wanted it to do, except possibly for the people who are getting paid to do this. The whole idea was that ethanol is going to be a clean fuel. It's going to be greener. It's going to be better for the environment. In fact, what you see is that ethanol is worse for the environment when you look at the overall picture, all of the transportation that's involved, all of the inefficiencies that are involved in a worse fuel. And at the same time, it also contributes to world hunger, because now what we're doing is we're paying farmers to burn corn, to create corn that is then burned for fuel rather than eaten. And what we need to do with food is eat it, and so that drives up the price of food globally, which for people who are very poor in third world countries is a huge problem. Even, you know, if you're living on $1 or $2 a day, even a few cents rise in the price of corn, which is a staple for much of the world, is just going to make a huge impact on your ability to feed yourself and your family.
And Suderman, the other sort of predictable, if unintended outcome of all of this is that you've got these concentrated benefits and these distributed costs. So these policies never ever seem to go away. Everyone seems to acknowledge that ethanol doesn't really make a lot of sense as an energy substitute if what we're concerned about is making the air cleaner. But the law hasn't gone anyplace. Why does it stay that way? Is anyone going to be able to get rid of this?
It is absolutely the concentrated benefits problem here, and the biggest defenders of ethanol are the people who benefit directly from it financially, and their legislators. And because they have legislators who talk about how great this program is, and you know how it's helping American farmers, that has made it very difficult to roll back the subsidies here. You've seen a little bit of movement where some of the subsidies have been cut off and then reinstated, things like that, but it's been very difficult. What I would say, though, is that little bit of movement that we've seen in the past couple of years, and some of the rejiggering of the way that that crop subsidies are managed in general, does suggest that in the medium term there may be some potential for Congress to come together and basically say, look, let's stop paying these guys to produce corn that goes into car engines. We need to be producing corn for people to eat. We need to not be harming American consumers and American cars, and making the global poor poorer and hungrier.
All right.